In today's video, we'll be going over what Shuhei Yoshida said about the PlayStation 5 and specifically what developers are telling him. Outside of that, as far as the PS5 updates go, we've also got a new PS5 DualShock 5 pen, and it's showing something pretty interesting about that controller. And then Square Enix's new AAA title by Luminous Productions won't be here anytime soon. I imagine that will be a PlayStation 5 game as well, so we'll cover that at the end of this video. First up, Shuhei Yoshida noted that developers are telling him that they've never worked on hardware as easy to develop on as the PlayStation 5. The latest issue of Dengeki PlayStation Magazine included an interview with Shuhei Yoshida, who explained Sony made it very easy to develop games on PS5. In the interview, Shuhei Yoshida explained how PlayStation 3 was by far the hardest console to develop on in its history, and how PlayStation 4 was specifically made to avoid repeating this mistake. If you guys don't remember, the PlayStation 3 was such a train wreck to develop for that, outside of just exclusivity agreements, some developers early on would just be like, okay, this thing is such a nightmare to develop for, we're not even gonna put our game on the PlayStation 3 because Sony butchered the architecture of the PlayStation 3 that has made it such a headache to develop for, that the Xbox 360 was just getting exclusives for free. Just think about that for a second. Microsoft didn't even have to do anything, but Sony just kind of shot themselves in the foot by the way they designed the PlayStation 3, that the 360 was just getting free exclusives. So that was a little bit funny from a consumer standpoint. However, from a Sony standpoint, obviously that was a very big problem, and a lot of multi-platform games even looked better on the 360 versus the PS3. And the PlayStation 3 had the superior hardware if you actually knew how to develop for it, and ultimately through the years, we did see that with games like Uncharted 2 and 3 and Last of Us. Those games from a technical standpoint were just not possible on the Xbox 360. But nonetheless, Shuhei Yoshida in this interview added that developers can focus on making their games if they need to focus on overcoming the inherent difficulty of developing on complicated hardware. As such, Sony is striving to make it as easy as possible to develop on PlayStation hardware. Yoshida said that's what the company had in mind when making the PS4, and that's what they have in mind for the PS5. The thing about the PlayStation 4 and the PlayStation 5 is the hardware itself, based on everything we've been told about the PS5, it's very comparable to PC hardware, and that's super easy to develop for, especially with a console when you have one static set of hardware. On PC, you've got all these different components that you can mix and match. On a console, it's just gonna be that one set of hardware that you're developing for, unless Sony decides to make like a PS5 Pro, but even then, you've only got two sets of static hardware. Even if you bump it up to three or four, that's not a big deal. With PC, you're talking about literally hundreds and hundreds of different configurations that are possible, and that does lend itself to having more issues. But nonetheless, Yoshida also mentioned that many developers are telling Sony that they never worked on a console as easy to develop on as PlayStation 5. We already saw in the past what is supposedly a PlayStation 5 dev kit, and needless to say, the biggest studios in the world are already working on major PlayStation 5 games. We already know that the next Dragon Age is in development, and you're kidding yourself if you think that's going to be a current generation title. We know that a bunch of first party studios like a Guerrilla Games, a Santa Monica, Naughty Dog, I'm sure, while they have Last of Us Part 2 in the pipeline and that's about to come out in May, you are kidding yourself if they're not at least thinking about another project that's going to come out on the PlayStation 5. And then you've got games like Gearbox's Godfall, and a lot of other studios are working on games. I mean, the launch isn't that far away at this point. A lot of these games are probably pretty far along, and we're probably going to see some of these games get officially revealed come early 2020 at that PlayStation event whenever they decide to hold that. Also, speaking of PS5, a new PS5 DualShock 5 patent shows controller with additional back buttons. In what seems to be something of a steady stream of patent leaks and details regarding Sony's forthcoming PlayStation 5 DualShock 5 controller, the latest patent info is regarding the controller for Sony's next generation console, and it points towards no less than 4 extra buttons. Now, this is pretty interesting because Sony just announced that they'll be releasing their own official DualShock 4 add-on where it's gonna have mappable buttons, but if that's just built into the DualShock 5 right from the get-go, I think that would be really good. Now, does that also add the question of this being an even more expensive controller? Because if you're adding something like that and it's retaining all of the fundamentals of the DualShock 4, the DualShock 4 still goes for what, $50 or $60? You throw on the add-on that they're about to release, that's another $30. You're talking about a $90 controller. Throw in tax and you're nearing that $100 mark. Are we talking about just having a $100 controller right out of the gate? That would be a big problem to me. If you're telling me that the PlayStation 5 is gonna come out and and every additional controller is going to be even $80. Let's say it's $80. That would be just a little bit too much, but it does seem like they're trying to enhance the controller even more, and we've seen it generationally. Every generation controllers get more and more expensive. I believe the PlayStation 2 controller started at $30. Then you had the PlayStation 3 controller. Hey, that had 6 axis and it was fully wireless. It was charged through USB. You didn't have to buy batteries or anything like that. That was like $45. Then we had the PlayStation 4 controller. Hey, that had a touchpad in it. Now you're talking about a $60 controller. Are we talking about a $70, $80 controller with this one? Man, these controllers are just getting so pricey, and most people want to have at least 2 controllers, if not more. Some people want to have 3 to 4 controllers, and that is such a big added cost. I've seen it in the comment section here and there, but you guys often get upset about controller price, and I think if they're trying to improve the controller even more, that's great. I'd love a better DualShock controller, even though the fundamentals of the DualShock controller are great. If they're trying to enhance it even more, I thought the touchpad was a good addition, but I just worry a little bit about the pricing of this controller, because again, every generation we've seen these steady price increases. With the PlayStation 5, it would be natural just to expect a price increase for the DualShock 5, but man, I think at this point we're getting a little bit too expensive with our controllers. But nonetheless, I do think the addition of back buttons could be great, and something like that being applied right out of the gate would be great, because yes, the PlayStation 4 is getting this back button attachment, but it's deep into the generation and developers aren't building their games ground up with this in mind. If the PlayStation 5 comes out with the back buttons ready to go, well then developers can alter game design and how they map controls and things like that, and that would be ultimately pretty beneficial for how the game plays. So I think this is a good addition, just very skeptical about the price point, because I do see a lot of people getting upset by that if it does end up being a $70, $80, God forbid $90 controller. That would be ridiculous. Alright, and lastly, I do want to talk a little bit about Square Enix's new AAA title by Luminous Productions, probably a PlayStation 5 game. I would almost guarantee you it's a PS5 game. However, in a Famitsu interview, developers at Luminous Productions praised the studio's work environment and shared a development update on their new AAA game. So it's a AAA game, not going to be a smaller downloadable or mobile game. This is going to be a pretty sizable game, and obviously the Luminous engine is a pretty grandiose engine, so you would expect it to be of a bigger game. However, Luminous Productions is one of the studios at Square Enix aiming to create new AAA IPs. The studio in the past was helmed by Hajime Tabata, working on Final Fantasy 15 and its Luminous engine. You know the story. Tabata left Square Enix in November of 2018, and Luminous Productions got a new leader in December of 2018. The new head is Takeshi Aramaki, and Famitsu just published an interview with 2 developers of Luminous Production, Saya Nakahara and Yuki Matsuzawa, a lead concept artist. The interview focuses mostly on the studio as a whole and their working conditions, but it was noted by Matsuzawa, quote, "There's not much we can tell you for now. We decided on certain elements of the game, but other elements are still under consideration. People like me who are at the top of the development process are very busy. It's a brand new IP, so some things about it are different compared to what we've done until now, meaning it's a project difficult to work on and takes a lot of time. Given it's a brand new project, given it's a Square Enix Japanese AAA games, guys, it's not going to be a PlayStation 4 game. It might not be a PlayStation 5 game. It might very well be a PlayStation 6 game. If you're familiar with Square Enix development cycles, you know it's an absolute train wreck. I mean, I can always point back to Final Fantasy 15, announced in 2005 or 2006. When did it come out? 2016. Obviously, that game was an even bigger train wreck than usual Square Enix Japanese game development standards, but even look at a game like Kingdom Hearts 3, announced at 2013, and then it ultimately came out in early 2019. That's still a 6-year window, and a lot can change in that time period, and with Square Enix, this being a brand new IP, not a continuation of an existing IP, it being done by a newer studio, and it being a AAA game, man, I do not have a lot of hope of seeing this game anytime soon, but let's hope that it does turn out to be really good, and let's hope it's a game that establishes a new franchise for Square Enix, because I've been saying it for the longest time, Square Enix needs to establish new IPs. They can always rest their laurels on Final Fantasy, Dragon Quest does relatively well, Kingdom Hearts, but they need to get new IPs rolling. Left Alive didn't do all that well. Quiet Man didn't do all too well. The Tomb Raider games, while Square Enix was publishing them, they didn't do all too well, especially with SOTR. They need to get the ball rolling on newer IPs. How could I forget Just Cause 4 as well? That game didn't do all too well. They really need to establish some IPs that people are enamored by, people are excited by, and I think with a new AAA title by Luminous Productions, it being noted as a new IP, I do think that has a lot of potential. We'll see how it turns out. We probably won't see it for a very long time. So that's gonna conclude this video. Again, Shuhei Yoshida developers are telling him that they've never worked on hardware as easy to develop for as PlayStation 5. A new DualShock 5 pen suggests that the PlayStation 5 DualShock 5 controller will be better. However, I am very, very skeptical at how expensive this controller is going to be. Let me know in the comment section. How would you react if standalone controllers were going for $70 to $90? Because I absolutely think that's a realistic possibility. And Square Enix's new AAA title by Luminous Productions is coming along. However, don't be expecting that game anytime soon. That's going to conclude this video. Sound off with all of your thoughts in the comment section down below. Thank you for watching and goodbye. Hey guys, we hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, make sure to hit the subscribe button, and if you're already subscribed, do us a favor and hit the bell icon. This way you'll be notified whenever we post a new video. That's the best way to keep up with all of our uploads, and we usually try to upload 2 videos a day. And with the bell icon hit, you'll be notified whenever we do upload a video. As always, thanks for watching.